Welcome friends, on this video Daniel is here from Tips to Fix, and today in this video tutorial we are going to do Windows 10 Home Edition or Pro Edition upgrade to LTSC version 2019 or 2021. So as we already know, Windows 10 Pro Edition or Home Edition will end support on October 14, okay, 2025. And Windows 11 23H2 will be end support in November 11, 2025. So now, if you want to upgrade to Windows LTSC version, then I'm going to show you today how to do it. But let me explain you a little bit what is the difference, okay? What is this LTSC version of a Windows 10? LTSC, it means long-term support channel. It means that you will have a version of Windows that will have long-term support. Version 2021, it will have support till 2027, and version 2019 will have support till 2032. For all of you guys that you need your computer for work and you need to keep this Windows 10 as long as possible, then this version of Windows is good for you. So guys, I'm here to help you, and let's go directly to the point and let's upgrade and let's see what it will happen in my computer, okay? Okay, here we are. First thing that we are going to do, guys, if your computer supports Windows 11 24H2, and if your processor is supporting SSE 4.2 and POPCNT, then you don't need to upgrade to Windows 10 LTSC. I suggest you going directly to Windows 11, the latest version, okay? If your computer is older than that and does not support Windows 11 latest version, if I open up my CPU-C, my processor here is Core 2 Quad, and this processor does not support SSE 4.2. It's 4.1, okay? Now, if I upgrade this computer to Windows 11 23H2, 23H2 will end support in 11 November 2025. Now, in this case, I have to keep Windows 10, but also I need to have the updates, security updates. We are going to upgrade to LTSC 2021, 21H2. I need to check also my language version. Here is the command that I use to check the version of Windows language. Mine is English United States, okay? Make sure when you download it, the ISO file, you have to have this ENUS, okay? Now, to be able to have Windows 10 LTSC version, you have to have an account here, okay? Access Volume Reach and Service Service. So, because this is how you can get officially. If you click here, Access Volume License, okay, you will be able to redirect to this page. All volume license services center functions can now be through the Microsoft 365 Admin Center. Now you have to have a Microsoft account, but not personal one. You need to have a company Microsoft account. If you are a developer, you can download directly from Visual Studio subscriptions portal, okay, dashboard. Now what I'm going to do, so I already have my ISO file here on the desktop, and is LTSC 2021. Now if you do mount here and open up, you will see if I start setup, install Windows 10, not right now, you will see this keep personal files only, this keep personal files and apps in this way, like this, is disabled. I don't suggest you continue because you will lose all the softwares that you already have installed. Let me show you exactly what we are going to do here. We are going to regedit, registry editor. Here on registry editor, find here local machine, software, Microsoft, Windows NT. Here it is, Windows NT, current version. Now, here we are. Now in the current version, what we are going to do, we need to edit some things here. For version 2021, here, this one, I'm going to use these parameters here. Okay, this is the name of the product that we need to replace. This one is okay. Current build, you have to change the current build from 19045, it will be 44. Click OK. Current build number 4 again here. Display version 21H2 is okay. This edition ID needs to be changed, needs to be Enterprise S, like this. Don't forget that. Click OK here. Now, this release will change on, I have to change on 21 H2. Okay. Click OK. Product name, I will change it to match exactly Windows 10 Enterprise LTSC. I will do it like this. Click OK. Everything is set right here. And what you gotta do now? Let's go again to this setup as we did before. Double click on setup. Okay. I don't want any downloads for the moment, guys. Click next. We are getting a few things ready. Ready to install. Change what to keep. Keep personal files and apps. Okay. Now, here we are. Before this option, it was grayed out. This is what I was talking about. We'll click next. We'll see if we have any errors or something. I need to see if I have all the softwares here after we install upgrade to this version of Windows 10. Okay. Click install. Installing process started. 21 complete. The computer will restart as always many times. So let's see the process, guys. Now this is considering this as update. Okay, computer restarted again. It took a little time. I mean, 15 minutes. Okay. It's old, guys. It's not new computer. So, oh, working on updates, 30%. Okay. 48. Now it will be faster. Do you see, guys? It gave me a crash. Interesting, guys. Nice. 57. Will crash again. It goes back or it's updated. I'm super curious now. 85%. So we saw an error. Freeze, boom, done. And directly. Now it's working on updates, 19%. I don't know why we get that error. We will see it later. I think GPU drivers gave that error. Display driver was the main problem of that error. I'm going to check for updates. Windows 10 Enterprise LTSC. NVIDIA display driver is downloading. So I'm leaving the computer to download and update all drivers, okay? So here we are, guys. After we upgrade to Windows 10 LTSC, the only issue that I faced was my NVIDIA GPU drivers. And what I did, I used this display driver uninstaller. I completely uninstalled my drivers, downloaded the latest one for NVIDIA Quadro M2000. And I install it again and everything works super well right now, okay? If you go ahead and see, here we are in Windows 10 Enterprise LTSC. You will see that I'm on the latest update. You see, all these cumulative updates are done today, okay? This is how you can upgrade from Windows 10 Home Edition or Pro Edition to LTSC, in my case, 2021. So what it will happen if you keep Windows 10 without any security updates? Nothing will happen if you are careful on browsing online, if you don't download everything you see online. Don't click that button, download everywhere, guys. You can get virus very easily, okay? I did another video tutorial how to keep your computer secure. So my best advice is switch to a new computer if you can. I hope this video was helpful for you, okay? If you're watching this video and you didn't subscribe my channel yet, if you wish this channel to grow up, please hit that subscribe button, guys. I promise that I will make super video tutorials for you guys, okay? Don't forget that. God bless you and see you on the next video tutorial.